بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Such an honor for me to participate in annual conference of the Manhur Nephrology Department. I am Dr. Ahmed Mabrouk Sheikh. I am nephrology consultant and head of nephrology department and medical insurance Tanta. Here is a part of our activities. كانوا كلنا منورين وده digital endorsement of our all of our patients are digitalized. And I'm glad to invite you to participate and attend our annual conference, which will be held at 2nd and 3rd February 2023. So we have a female patient, 26 years old, no history of any previous diseases, presented with dyspnea with effort. CBC revealed hemoglobin 7.5 gram. Iron study, occult blood stool, and renal function were requested. Renal function creatinine was 6.8. Nephrology referral, positive family history of end-stage kidney disease, her aunt on hemodialysis for 18 years since she was 28 years old. Her native kidney disease is cystic kidney disease. Otherwise, all her family members are medically free. Full investigation requested shows pelvic abdominal ultrasound, bilateral grade 3 nephropathies, and atrophied kidneys. Chronicity profile was very significant. I told the patient and her family that to start for preparation for RRT, either transplantation or dialysis. I told them that dialysis is good, but transplantation is the best. So her mother is seeking for kidney donation, pre-emptive transplantation, female, 47 years old, history of morbid obesity. She was diabetic for 2 years. After that, she underwent gastric bypass 8 years ago. Stopped anti-diabetic medication since 7 years. On examination, normal blood pressure, random blood sugar is 135 milligram, and body weight declined from 146 to 101. BMI is right now is 29. More diabetic assessment, fasting and postprandial blood sugar was normal. Glucose tolerance test was normal. Hemoglobin A1C is 4.8. And albumin creatinine ratio is negative, so normal. So in the colonoscopy confirmed that this patient is not diabetic or have any complication of diabetes. More and more investigation, recipient immunological profile were free, virology for the donor, for the recipient, sorry, AIDS is negative, Hep C is negative, while I was surprised that Hep B is positive. The patient is single version and no history of any surgical intervention or blood transfusion. But with more and more investigations, the patient with recurrent visits for the dentist. So I called my hepatologist and liver transplant physician in our team for more liver assessment. So liver function was normal, and the PCR, HBV PCR was 155,000. Detection and pelvic abdominal ultrasound was normal. So I asked him, I should request a fibro scan or liver biopsy, but he said that we have a guidelines for that, that EASL guidelines was released in 2017. If a patient without cirrhosis and HBV DNA more than 20,000, so we will start for, we'll go for medication, start of medication, right? While an AASLD, the American Association of Liver Disease, management of hepatitis B in non-liver solid organ transplantation recipient, all hepatitis B organ transplant recipients should receive lifelong potent antiviral therapy to prevent or to treat reactivation of Hep B after transplantation. So which will give for a treatment, it's an oral treatment, 0.5 for compensated and naive patient liver disease, such as entecavir. But entecavir, what will be the dose? The dose according to creatinine clearance, don't need a dose adjustment. It will be 0.5, one tablet every 7 days. So the patient will continue for this medication for life. So I asked about drug-drug interaction, especially with immunosuppression. It was negative, or acute crystal nephrosis as other antivirals. It not there is no negative for anticrystals. So I went for go for matching by negative was negative by cross matching by DDT and the flow cytometry. Both of them is negative. So I will continue for matching and tissue typing. To summarize it in this table, the recipient donor is A positive, cross match is negative. Matching was excellent. It was a mismatching was 1/6 with one B, one in class B, one only is mismatching with no DSA. So movement and more investigation for the donor, but unfortunately we have right renal small cyst, cortical cyst, measured 18 milli. So the CT renal angio revealed this cyst. This cyst was a Bosnick 1, its size is 52 millimeter, it's around 5.2 يعني سنتي. Okay, so Bosnick, it's Bosnick 1, it's only a simple cyst, and it's not a contraindication for donation, and for exclusion of any adult polycystic kidney disease, as her sister was a cystic kidney disease. This is the guidelines or the approach if the patient is more than 40 and have one or less than of have or equal one cyst, it's not an autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease, and this is incomprehensive also as well from 40 to 59 and have more than or equal two cysts, it's not a autosomal dominant polycystic kidney. So we go for isotopic scan. It revealed GFR is for left kidney is 52.5 while the right is 43.2. Right here جبنا العيلة بقى وقعدنا معاهم her family we told them that to write and consent that her maybe the possibility that creatinine not landed to normal, and we will start with the donor and the recipient will still at her room. Will donor and we will see intraoperative kidney condition cyst. So دي الموافقة بتاعت الزرع. Recipient array assessment after 3 months. Creatinine elevated to 9.4. Hemoglobin improved. The patient is still on tegavir for the 3rd month. And HBV DNA PCR is 28. It's approximately normal. And you can and after consultation of hepatologist, he said it's nearly normal. And you can proceed for transplantation right now. So transplantation plan is 3 hemodialysis session pre-transplantation. Immunosuppression protocol is mismatching is good. No DSA, low risk protocol, low steroids protocol. Dry body weight is 71 kg. So 1 week before KTX, we started TAC 0.1 milli per kg. And 2 days before we started MBA full dose to tablet twice. Intraoperative OR. So that is, here is the cyst. ده كان فيديو مفروض بس مش عايز يشتغل. ايوه شكرا. احنا عاملين وصايا انت عشان كان في شتايم وحاجات. دي برضه بعد البلانشنج, دي بعد البرفيوجن السيست اللي هي الابر على الابر كده, واللور دي اللي هي اللي كانت بلانشد توتالي بلانشد وكانت برفيوزد ويل برفيوزد. دي برضه فيديو ده مع بوست ديكلامبنج على طول. ممكن نشغله الفيديو معلش. بوست ديكلامبنج الحمد لله برضه جابت يورين على طول, بس احنا كنا طولنا جدا في العمليات, اخذنا حوالي 6-7 ساعات يعني, وما عرفناش نجيب السيست لان الفيلد كله كان بلاد, لان كان فيه كولاترز كتيره وحصل بليدنج الصراحه كتير, فالهيموجلوبين نزل لغايه يعني 7.5 كده, وبعدين تمام. وبوست اوبريتيف لاب كان الهيموجلوبين 6.4, كرياتين كان 5.3. ده طبعا بعد 3 سيشن الدياليسيز. بوست اوب دي 1 درين 300 والبيشنت ريسيفت 3 نوت باكد ار بي سيز فلدر ريتيتد على اساس ان هي ممكن تزرع تاني قدام لان لسه صغيره. وادس تشارج هيموجلوبين 8, كرياتينين 1.3, سي ار بي وز اراوند نورمال, التاك ليفل وز 6, ابجريدنج التاك فروم 3 تو 4, والانتكافير ادجستد دوز اون النيو كرياتين كليرنس ويتش وز نورمال, اتس 0.5 وانس بير داي فور لايف. بعد اسبوع من اول فيزيت, بعد اسبوع هيموجلوبين از 8, بدات العينه انديوز دراج انديوز دايابيتس, الاف كي ليفل واز 14.9, بدانا نقلل تاني, وبعدين الكرياتين كان 0.4, نقللنا تاني التاك ل 3.3, رجعنا في كلامنا, الكرياتين بقى 1. وده بدي صوره باي ماي اون الترا ساوند ان ماي كلينك. This is the cyst and I requested a Doppler. It's only it's totally free kidney with upper bowel multilobular cyst. 2 weeks post op, donor slipped and got her leg fractured. 2 days later, his sister called me that the donor suffered from two syncopal attacks. The patient sinus tachycardia around to be shocked. The new ECG and echo requested. unfortunately patient donor suffered from acute pulmonary embolism. So they told me to they proceed for CT pulmonary angio. I told them to request creatinine. Creatinine was 0.4. So I ثانية واحدة خلص. So CT angio was done and bilateral pulmonary embolism. And I asked what about thrombolytic medications, but the ECC guidelines 2019 said that it's contraindicated if major trauma or major surgery done in the previous 3 weeks. So patient was in regimen of heparin infusion. And this is a picture of her discharge day. Donation is about life giving and giving life. شكراً.